I was just there. They said Ariel left hours ago.
Who is by? Mr. Cranston.
Good evening, Reverend. I was just looking for Ariel.
Isn't it a bit late, Mr. Cranston?
Yes, sir. That is why I am surprised that she is not at home.
So am I. Well, good night, Mr. Cranston. And next time, please remember we have a front door for guests.
Yes, sir.
Where is she?
She told me she was going to Wendy Jo's to study. Don't bother calling. She's not there.
Did you know this?
No, I did not.
So, how does it feel, Vi, now that she's lying to you?
I'm not saying anything until I hear an explanation from her.
It was frightening enough when she was running around with Chuck Cranston. Now she's out in the middle of the night with that punk whose campaign challenged me and the entire town council. How long can you keep defending her?
I am not defending her. We are not on opposite sides here, are we? Or are we?
Where were you?
We know you weren't at Wendy Jo's. I can't believe you're checking up on me. Sweetie, how do we know you're not sick or hurt?
I'm concerned for your well-being.
How come when I'm at home you're never interested in what I'm thinking or how I feel? But the minute I walk out that door, wham! Suddenly you're the concerned parent.
She doesn't mean that, Shaw.
Stop taking her side. She has to answer for herself.
I don't know what good that would do. You don't listen to me any more than you listen to her.
Don't
Shaw!
I've never hit anyone.
I know.
I don't understand what's happening. I don't know what to do anymore.
Yes, you do. And you find it in your heart to forgive her. Can you stop and see there's part of her that's trying to obey, while part of her is dying to run away? And you find it in your soul to accept her. If she stumbles on your holy path, do you have to reprimand? Or are there ways to make her understand? Of using the back of your hand. Can't you remember when we were that age, pumped up with promise? Does it ever cross your mind that I miss you?